observance of the provisions of the Public Procurement Act 2007, which have become very imperative. This should start with procurement planning, the entire bidding process, which ensures competition, prevents bid rigging, and ensures value for money. Two, provisions should be meant for maintenance of these solutions by the contractor for a guaranteed length of time and not just an install and abandon basis. This is because some components require replacement after a certain period of time, and just installing and abandoning will reduce their full lifespan value. Three, contractors should be paid fully upon expiration of the standard warranty period of their solutions. Government should also consider giving the contractors retainership contracts after the guarantee period to ensure maintenance and optimal functioning of the facilities. Four, to standardize prices and avoid inflation of contract works, the Bureau of Public Procurement, in accordance with its mandate, should provide a price database of renewable energy components to all federal MDAs and update them from time to time based on changing macroeconomic indicators. Contracting agencies should work closely with reputable bodies in the sector, such as Sustainable Energy Practitioners Association of Nigeria, SEPAN, Renewable Energy Association of Nigeria, REN, who have experienced professionals in the sector and can facilitate the vetting of bids on renewable energy projects. It is also imperative to strengthen the monitoring, inspection, and approval units of federal MDAs for proper monitoring of the standard and quality of work done by contractors, functionality of the projects, and ascertain if these projects were actually executed in accordance with specifications. We need to rationalize projects and stop spreading resources too thin, including budgets only those projects that can be adequately funded within a reasonable period of time. Complete existing projects before embarking on new ones. Executing MBAs in a bid to ensure sustainability should consider training of some capable local hands on basic maintenance of the renewable systems, such as cleaning of the panels and changing of the LED bulbs. Innovative designs of solar project solutions should be adopted to prevent the theft of solar components. There now exist integrated solar solutions with all the components merged into one, unlike the solution used for projects, which are more like an assemblage of various components. These new products reduce the risk of theft of components, they are better quality, and last longer when compared with the usual solutions. For the Federal Ministry of Works, Power and Housing, in accordance with Section 88 of the Electric Power Sector Reform Act of 2005, the Minister of Power should expedite the preparation and approval of, by the President of the Rural Electrification Strategy and Plan and the setting up of the accompanying Rural Electrification Fund. He should also ensure that the quarterly reports are prepared, presented to the President, and disseminated to the public. For the Federal Minister of Environment, which is the country's designated national authority and the UNFCCC focal point, it should nominate a group of non-state actors, for instance, selected CSOs, to undergo the capacity building exercise being offered free of charge by the climate change body. It will not cost Nigeria anything, but will bring her a lot of benefits in terms of capacity. Nigeria should start the process of measuring, reporting, and verification, and annual verification by designated operational entities, certify emission reduction with a view to earning carbon credits. The country should take steps to assess international funds like Green Climate Funds, Nationally Appropriate Mitigation Action Funds, Climate Change Adaptation Funds Direct Access Modality, Community Development Carbon Fund of the World Bank, ETC. Nigeria should also initiate steps and properly position herself to lead the sub-region in matters pertaining to climate change mitigation and adaptation, and become a hub for low-carbon technology transfer for the sub-region, West Africa Emission Reduction Trading System, Scheme. For the legislature, the National Assembly, in collaboration with the Federal Ministry of Budget and National Planning, should adopt a framework and template for the selection of projects to be included in the federal budget as constituency projects. The framework should take cognizance of the policy plan and budget continuum, which guarantees that the annual budget is used as a vehicle to implement policies and plans which mitigate and adapt to climate change. For the Ministry of Budget and National Planning, the ministry should ensure that estimates that will be included in the federal budget bill are based on the existing national plans and policies. This will ensure that renewable energy projects are fitted into the national engineering policies and action plans for the standard organization of Nigeria. Seoul should adequately regulate the quality of solar equipment being imported to ensure that only components meeting the required standards are allowed into the country. It should also collaborate with federal MDAs to ensure that the components used for solar and renewable energy installations are of the required quality and standard. It should also consider facilitating capacity building in federal MDAs that use renewable energy products to put them in a position to properly monitor and vet the results of public renewable energy procurements. For communities and CSOs, they should take ownership of these renewable energy solutions and projects, including being responsible for their security and protection against vandalism. But this requires proper community consultation and engagement by project promoters at the time of the initiation of the project. Use can also be trained on basic maintenance of these solutions, such as cleaning of the solar panels at intervals. CSOs can intervene to provide appropriate training and capacity building. Under well-defined agreements with MDAs, the proper maintenance of such projects should be used as a prerequisite for the location of other developmental projects in the same communities. And communities or their local governments should review FGM budgets to determine which projects have been allocated to their communities and as such, follow up, monitor, and ensure that the responsible parties implement the projects according to specifications. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the report on solar energy and the federal budget. I'll pause for a few minutes for a few discussions before, for a few questions before we move to the second reports.